In this example, we are going to investigate what is called the null space of a matrix. So the particular matrix that we'll work with in this problem is the matrix A, and it is defined right here. It is a 3x3 matrix, and we are going to be interested in determining if certain vectors are in the null space of A or not in the null space of A. So in first part here, in part A, we are given the vector x, which is the 3x1 vector 1, 1, 2, and we are asked, is this vector in the null space of A? So matrices have null spaces, and those null spaces consist of all the vectors such that AX equals the all zero vector. So if I can find a vector X such that AX equals 0, 0, 0 in this case, then X is in the null space. And if AX is not equal to the all zero vector, then it is not in the null space. So when you're given a matrix and you're given a vector and asked to check, is this vector in the null space? That's a pretty simple thing to do. You really just need to form the matrix vector product AX and compute to see what it's equal to. So in this case, we write down the matrix A, we write down the vector X, we perform the matrix multiplication. So I'm going to get 1 times that, negative 2, 6, negative 10, and a negative 4, 3, 8. So after I form the product A times X, I end up with this vector right here. So you can see what I did. I just did my normal this row times this linear combination to get minus 2, minus 9, minus 10, and then 2, negative 6, 5 times this to get a negative, to get 2, negative 6, 10, and then finally this times this to get the final row. So if I add all these up, a negative 2 minus 9 minus 2 is equal to a negative 13. 2 minus 6 minus 10 is equal to a negative 14. And minus 4 minus 3 plus 8 is equal to 1. So after computing A times X, I end up with the vector a negative 13 and negative 14, 1, which is obviously not equal to 0, 0, 0. So this vector that we were given, 1, 1, 2, is not in the null space because I did not end up with the vector 0, 0, 0. So that was pretty easy. Let's do another quick example. Let's check to see if this vector is in the null space of A. So again, our approach is exactly the same. To figure out if a given vector is in the null space, all we need to do is take A times X. And again, if I do that, I'm going to end up with first that row times that column element-wise would be a negative 26 plus 36 minus 10. And then the next entry will be this row times that. So I'll end up with 26 plus 24 minus 50. And then finally, the last entry in the vector will be that row times that column, element-wise. So a negative 52 plus 12 plus 40. And you can see what happens here if I add these up now. A negative 26 plus 36 minus 10 is really a negative 36 plus 36, which is 0. And then similarly here, 26 plus 24 is 50. 50 minus 50 is 0. And then finally right here, I have a negative 52 plus 12 plus 40. 12 plus 40 is 52. A negative 52 plus 52 is 0. And I end up with the all 0 vector. So I took the matrix A, I multiplied it by X, I ended up with the all 0 vector. So by definition of the null space, that means that this vector X must be in the null space of A. So that's the end of this example. We now know how to check if for a given matrix and for a given vector, if the matrix is in the null space, and all you have to do is multiply A times X. If you don't get the all zero vector, it is not in the null space. And if you get the all zero vector, it is in the null space.